Konnichiwa. Welcome to Learn Japanese with Masa Sensei. My name is Masa and I am teaching Japanese grammar for beginners. Today in this lesson, we will learn about another new expression for causes and reasons, which is tameni. So in my two previous videos, we have learned about three different types of causes and reasons expressions, which is から, ので, で, and today we will learn the fourth one, which is ために. ために indicates causes and reasons and is often used when a certain cause brings a bad result. For example, since it is snowing, I cannot go outside. Since it is snowing, I cannot go outside. So, snowing is 雪が降っています. So, 降ります is fall. 雪が降ります. The snow falls. So, we have to change into ing form, which is 降っています. 降っています. So, you make it to plain form, 降っている. And then you put together with ため. 雪が降っているため外に出られません。So you can also use 雪が降っているために外に出られません。So 外 is outside. 出られません is potential form, which means cannot go out. Let's do another one. Since today is cold, I wear a sweater. Since today is cold, I will wear a sweater. 寒い cold. So you put ため after the adjective. 今日は寒いためセーターを着ます。今日は寒いため、セーターを着ます。セーター is sweater. So after I adjective, you just put ため。For example, another one is, since it is raining, the match was cancelled. Since it is raining, the match was cancelled. 雨のため試合が中止になりました。雨のため試合が中止になりました。So this 雨 is a noun. So you put のため. And then 試合 is match. 中止になりました. Became cancelled. So after a noun, you put のため or のために. So now we are using のため or ために, but we can also replace with other expression for reasons and causes. For example, we have learned だから. So remember, in my previous video, we have learned から. から also means because. In this case, I will say 雨だから試合が中止になりました。雨だから試合が中止になりました。After a noun or not adjective, you put だ. And then, から. 雨だから試合が中止になりました。We have learned another one, which is ので. So the difference between から and ので is ので is more polite and it sounds softer. If you want to use ので, you put なので. So after noun and な adjective, it becomes なので. So, 雨なので試合が中止になりました. 雨なので試合が中止になりました. And we have also learned で, noun plus で. So, で is used for after natural phenomenon or disaster. 雨で試合が中止になりました. 雨で試合が中止になりました. So these are all same meaning. It means because something something or since something something. Let's do another example. Because of sickness, I was absent from school. Because of sickness, I was absent from school.
病気のため学校を休みました. 病気のため学校を休みました.
So, 病気 is a noun. After that, you put のため or のために. If it's から, it will become
病気だから学校を休みました. 病気だから学校を休みました.
If it's ので, it becomes
病気なので学校を休みました.
病気なので学校を休みました. And the last one, if it's noun plus で, it becomes
病気で学校を休みました. 病気で学校を休みました.
So be careful after noun or na adjective, it becomes
なので、だから.
So these are the two differences. And another usage of ために. So this is not the reason or causes, but ため or ために means means for the sake of, in order to, for the benefit of. If I want to say, I am studying Japanese for you. I am studying Japanese for you. So let's say your boyfriend or girlfriend is a Japanese. So in order to speak with them, you are learning Japanese. In this case, you say,
あなたのために日本語を勉強しています。 あなたのために日本語を勉強しています。
So after noun, it's のために. For you, あなたのために. After a verb, it will become plain form plus ために. So if I say,
痩せるために毎日運動しています。 痩せるために毎日運動しています。
In order to lose weight, I do sports every day.
痩せます。 痩せる is to lose weight.
So these are the two different meanings of のために and のため. Okay, so thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, please comment down in the box below. ありがとうございます。バイバイ。